Welcome, SDocs users. This video will take you step by step through the process of creating your very first SDocs template. SDocs is 100% native to Salesforce, so creating your first SDocs template is a simple process. In our example today, we're going to create a template to track the progress of our opportunities. This template will generate a PDF of all our desired opportunity info. We can create an SDoc job to have it regularly emailed to us and our team members, keeping us on top of our opportunities and the required next steps. This is what our final PDF will look like. Now, let's make it. From the homepage of Salesforce, navigate to the SDocs app by clicking the app launcher in the top left corner. It looks like four boxes. Once installed, you'll find the SDocs app there. Once in the app, click on SDocs templates and then New SDoc template. Let's go through the template fields available before moving forward with our example. The template name is simple and important. Make it something descriptive so you and your team can find it. Same goes for the description. It can also be used for context and clarity for you and your team. Document category is an optional pick list field that you can use for organizational purposes. Group together similar documents for easy browsing or simply leave this pick list as none. You must pick an object from the related to type pick list. This is the base object the template will use. If needed, you can customize this list with your custom objects. You must also select a template format from the pick list. To support the same document in multiple formats, simply clone the template, and once completed, change the format field value in the duplicate template. The document version field is optional. Use this field to track any internally used version number or date for this template, or simply leave it blank. The Available for Use box is checked by default. Leave it checked so you and your team can use the template. Then decide whether you want this template to be initially visible. Leave this box checked if you want this template visible on initial load of your SDocs document creation page for its object type. If this box is not checked, the template will not appear when the end user's template selection page has initially loaded, but they can still use that template by finding it with the search bar on the template selection page. Best practice is to set this checkbox for the 10 most used templates for each object type. In this example, we're going to create an opportunity sheet template. This is an internal document that will circulate every day, tracking all updates to every opportunity in our Salesforce instance. So, we'll name our template Opportunity Sheet. We want to make sure our document is available for use and visible. Since this document is tracking opportunities, we will set the related to type to Opportunity, and we'll have it be an easy to consume PDF file. Go ahead and click Save. We now see our Opportunity Sheet template. To start drafting, go ahead and click on the drop-down caret in the upper right-hand corner of our template, and then select Template Editor. Now we're in the Template Editor where we can design our template. I'll start by simply putting a sort of title up top, Opportunity Tracking. This is static text, so it will never change. If we want this document to give us up-to-date info pulled from our opportunities, we need to insert merge fields. For this doc, we want to auto-populate the opportunity ID, the stage, and the opportunity revenue. For clarity in the final doc, I'll include labels before each of the merge fields I'm going to insert. Now, let's insert our actual merge fields. Go ahead and place the cursor where you want your Salesforce record data to be merged into the template, and then click the Insert Field button. We'll find our corresponding opportunity field, in this case the opportunity ID, and then click the Insert button. The merge field is now there. This will dynamically populate with the corresponding opportunity ID from our Salesforce record. We will do the same for stage and revenue. Go ahead and find the merge fields for opportunity stage name and opportunity amount. As we're building the template, we can use the Save and Preview button to see how the generated document will actually look as a PDF with data merged in. To enable the Save and Preview button, go to the Advanced Options tab of the Template Editor and paste in an opportunity ID in the Save and Preview box. You only have to do this step once. We can now click Save and Preview to see how our finished opportunity sheet will look with all the merge fields populated. we now have a ready-to-go SDocs template. You can put more plain text around the merge fields for context, or add more merge fields to better track the progress and pending actions on your active opportunities. You now know how to create templates in SDocs. Visit the resources page on sdocs.com for more written and video tutorials on how to get the most out of document generation and automation with SDocs.